to the world. Subscribe now to the Hot 97 YouTube channel. It's Ebro in the Morning with Laura Stiles and Rosenberg.
The baby was at a North Carolina home on Wednesday when a person trespassing was shot.
His North Carolina home or a?
So when I'm, according to reports, it belongs to a family member. So it's under a family member's name, but people are assuming that it's also his home. A 26-year-old man allegedly climbed the fence surrounding the property, and he was shot. You know,
and so he lived, now, no right? Charges. Good.
Yeah. But, I mean, this person was clearly trying to break into somebody's home.
Well, that's how you get shot, fam.
So, you know, like CNN said that they can't confirm that the baby owns a home. It's a family. It doesn't matter. Somebody was trespassing. Because...
there's only one thing I can take away from this story, okay? And it's not going to be what you think.
Okay.
It's in no way saying, here's what everyone thinks I'm going to say. Oh, the baby got in trouble. Surprise. No, his home was invaded. He shot someone, didn't kill them. Good job. Sounds like, right?
Yep.
The part of the story that I couldn't stop thinking about was that if you read the article, Laura, they went in, broke into Lil Baby's $2.3 million compound. And I was like, in North Carolina, $2.3 million will get you a compound?
Yeah.
God dang! What are we doing?
I know. It was huge when I saw pictures of the estate.
Bro. No. We slipping, bro.
Ebro, $2 million.
No, Rosenberg, you don't have to say it twice. Hit us with the button. What are we doing?
What are we doing?
Congratulations.
A compound?
Yourself. Yo, North Carolina's on the come up, too. Like, if you're paying attention, North Carolina over the next 5-10 is going to be... place to be.
$2.3 million here. Let me tell you, I've been looking. It'll get you about 3 bedrooms, 1,300 square feet in a decent building. Not a compound.
In other news, you guys saw Elon Musk. His $43 billion offer to buy Twitter. He said it was his best and final offer to buy Twitter. At a fat $43 billion, straight cash.
Now, here's the deal. If you're watching this, Elon Musk wants to take Twitter private. And he thinks it needs to be a more, what's the words they use? Like,
well, he keeps fighting for freedom of speech.
Right, ungoverned platform. Mm-hmm. Because a week ago, Elon Musk was trying to join the board, like, and so the word is, while he made the offer, he also yesterday had like a presser or some sort of, he was on something, talking. Said it's not even about the finances for him. He's not worried about making money on it.
He just wants it.
He wants it, and he thinks it should be more of an open platform.
But what does that mean? Because Twitter...
That means people say what they want to say when they want to say it on there.
Because for the most part, they do. There's very few things that they regulate. Very few. Sometimes I look at some tweets and I say, I can't believe this is like people straight using the N-word, hard R. If you look at it, you're like, how is this allowed?
Yeah.
And why would you want that? I mean, I don't know.
Because why? Because people who are like Elon Musk aren't affected by talk on Twitter. They don't care. They want to be able to say what they want to say, and they believe that people should just be able to say it. They don't care about the ramifications of reckless talk.
Yeah, well, when you have that much money, what ramifications are there?
Gross.
They don't feel ramifications.